It's yesterday, and you will stick by yesterday.
How do you feel about being branded one of the guilty men?
You're very silent, Mr. Corrigan.
One of the victims, Mari Wilson, was with her father when the bomb exploded.
And then I was aware of somebody squeezing my hand. And Mari said, "Is that you, Dad?" And I said, "Yes." "She said, are you all right?" I said, "Yes, but my hand's sore. How are you, dear?" "All right." Then I heard her scream. Asked her again, "How are you, Mari? Are you all right?" "Yes." She was gripping my hand very tightly. I was bleeding from the forehead. Knew I'd hurt myself. But I was assured that she was all right. She told me twice. She told me again, but she still was screaming in between times, and I couldn't understand why. On the one hand, she was telling me she was all right, and on the other hand, she was screaming. When I asked her for the fourth or fifth time, she said, "Daddy, I love you very much." Those were the last words she spoke. I should never forget them.
On Tuesday, 48 hours after the tragedy, the shattered community gathered to bury the dead. Dozens joined Gordon Wilson for a service of thanksgiving for the life of his daughter, Mari.
Being of such a radiant, lively personality, she had immediate rapport with all the patients that came under her care. Her friendliness, her sense of humor, her sincerity won for her many friends among staff and students.
Just 20 years old, Mari Wilson was a popular girl, and her loss was deeply felt. Police Constable Edward Armstrong was buried with full honours. He was off duty on Sunday and had stopped to watch the Remembrance Day parade on his way to church. Retired policeman Sam Galt was another of the victims. Eight other funerals followed over the next 2 days. Then, less than 20 miles from Enniskillen, the army discovered another bomb. It, too, had been placed on the route of a remembrance parade.
Is it the 4th line, right?
The police believe the bomb was expected to explode at the same time as the one at Enniskillen during the remembrance ceremony. But they think the IRA man at the end of the detonation wire was disturbed by the security operations. Among those seriously injured at Enniskillen was 15-year-old Stephen Ross. Specialists are having to rebuild his face, and he's courageously fighting back. Stephen's heart stopped while he was being flown to hospital, but 4 days after surgery, he's lively and cheerful again.
Well, I feel very well. The nurses and doctors have been great to me. I've just just slightly sore in my mouth. I have a fractured pelvis on this leg. And this leg's broken down to the bottom. But it's plastered, and I can feel no pain at all in either leg. Now, thanks to this metal frame here, my face is in one piece. Unfortunately, my teeth are wired together, so that's why my speech is a bit distorted.
So have you got a message for all those who've sent messages of goodwill to you?
Well, I'm glad to see them, and I'll be looking forward to seeing them. I'll be back in Gefilte, working order.
The ceremony at the Cenotaph in London went ahead as usual, nobody aware of Enniskillen. There was tight security for the service in Whitehall. Queen and the political leaders were unaware of the bomb in Enniskillen as they laid their wreaths. After the service, there was a march past by veterans to the sound of favourite water.